Okay, are you laying comfortably?
Yes.
Great, then if you're ready, we're going to start the first scan. Is that okay?
Yes, I'm ready.
We are in the magnetic resonance imaging lab of the Donders Institute, and here we investigate the human brain.
Where we can measure different things like the structure, the function, and the chemistry of the human brain.
So with brain structure, we look at what the brain looks like, the form, the shape, how big certain areas are. With function, we look at activation in the brain. And with neurochemistry, we can look at chemical messengers in our brain and how much there is present of them.
So we can use this kind of technique for many different things. We can look at, for example, what happens in the brain when we perceive the world, what happens when we try to make decisions. But we can also go into a more clinical kind of research where we look at what happens in the brain when you have different kinds of disorders, or if you have injuries in your brain, or for example, if you have a different kind of developmental disorders like autism or ADHD. The MRI machine is a very big magnet, and that's why we ask the participants to take off all their metal and their belts and stuff like that, so that it doesn't get sucked into the machine, because that can be very dangerous.
And what we see here is a slice through the middle of the brain, so the right half, and this here is the front, this is from above, from below, and the back of the brain. And with MRI, we're looking into the brain, but we're making slices, so every few centimeters we cut through it virtually, and then we can look at the brain from all sides, for instance from the side, but also from above and from the front.
So what we actually measure to take an anatomical picture of the brain is the reaction of the water molecules in the brain to the magnetic field. So there are different amounts of water in different tissues in the brain. So for example, you can see here the lighter parts is called white matter, and then the darker things on the outside here is called the gray matter, and then the darker stuff here is a liquid that's called cerebrospinal fluid. And since they all have different amounts of water in them, we can see the differences between them here.
After the MRI scan that we take in the lab, we are analyzing this data in our offices. And for that, we're using a server that contains 1.2 million gigabytes of storage and also power to analyze this data.
So participants come here, which can be both healthy volunteers or from a clinical group. So for example, if you have patients with some kind of disease or a disorder, they all come here. And come into the scanner, and usually an experiment takes about an hour. Sometimes it can take 2 hours, it can take 30 minutes as well. It's different for different projects. Sometimes it can be maybe 20 to 30 to 50 participants in one project, and sometimes it's 100 or 200. So that can also be very different depending on what kind of project and research we're doing.
So what I mainly focus on is autism spectrum disorder, and I'm interested in the neurochemistry of that, looking at a balance between the most important neurotransmitters in our brain, glutamate and GABA. And what we're thinking in autism is that those two neurotransmitters that are actually involved in all performances that we do, all our behavior, that they are out of balance in autism. And what I'm focusing on is this region here, which is the visual cortex, which is involved in processing how we look at the world. And the idea within autism is that there is difficulties with processing with our visual world, and that is reflected in a disbalance between this glutamate and GABA concentrations.
So the benefits of doing this research can be many different things. If you look at neurodevelopmental disorders like in autism, for example, if you understand how the disorder works in more detail, then you can develop better treatments or therapies or medication in the future. So that's one of the main goals of what we are doing here.